Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how I make beef stew or beef curry. This beef stew or curry is prepared using meat and bone together. But here I have used meat without bones. This stew is made regularly back home. The most important thing is to start with the right cut of meat. You can use beef or lamb in this preparation. I love to slow cook it and serve it with some crusty bread. I have added only potatoes, but you can add carrots also to this. It enhances the taste. I love to have this with crusty bread, but it goes well with rice as well as rotis. You can use a pressure cooker to fasten the process. So let's check out the ingredients. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you like this recipe of mine, do give a thumbs up and click the like button. If you have tried this recipe, please leave a comment in the comment section below. So let's get started. Here I have taken 1 kg of meat. Add salt as per taste. And around 3-4 teaspoons of chili powder. And 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder and boil the meat till it is 75% done. Don't boil it completely, otherwise it will become very mushy. You can use a pressure cooker, but I am cooking it in the open pan, just covering the lid of the pressure cooker but not giving it a pressure. Now for masala, I have taken 1 1/2 teaspoon of coriander seeds and then dry roast them. 3-4 teaspoon of peppercorns, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon of sonf, 4 cardamoms, 1 black cardamom, 6 cloves, 1/4 piece of star anise. I have broken it into pieces. 4 to 5 pieces of cinnamon sticks. Dry roast it without oil till it releases a nice aroma of the spices. If you want, you can avoid this step and use only ready-made garam masala powder or garam masala which you have at hand. Take 1 small onion, 4 pods of garlic and fry it in a teaspoon of oil. The onion should be nice and soft. It need not be brown, but it will take around a minute or so. You have to grind this onion, garlic with the dry spices to a nice fine paste. We call it alian in Konkani. Once this is done, add a small piece of tamarind. Now the flame is switched off. Add around 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Remember, we have added 1/2 teaspoon when boiling the meat. Once cool, then you can grind it to a paste. This is around 8 to 9 garlic, 1 inch piece of ginger, 3 to 4 green chilies, 1 large tomato, 2 onions sliced and a few curry leaves. You can chop it into cubes also. In a pan, I am using the pressure cooker. Use a heavy bottom pan, add oil as required and then start by adding the onions. When the onions are a little soft, you can start adding the other masalas. Add 1 bay leaf and fry till the onion is a little soft. Not completely soft, but just. Then add the ginger, garlic and green chilies and curry leaves. Fry well for a minute or so till the onion garlic releases its aroma. At this point of time, add a little salt. Go slow on the salt as we have added salt while the meat was boiling. Add the chopped tomatoes. And now you have to cook till everything is nice and mushy. If you don't want to add water, you can add a little extra oil and fry it. But I do add water and cook it at this point of time. Add another half teaspoon of turmeric powder and fry this well for another minute or so. This is the boiled meat. Reserve the stock, and at this point of time add the stock in the onion mixture and let it cook till the onions, tomatoes, ginger, garlic, everything is nice and soft. Cover it with the lid and cook it nicely. See, here you can see it is cooked nicely. The onions have become nice and soft and mushy. Now add the meat. This meat is 75% done. Give it a nice good mix. And then you can add the vegetables. Here I have added only potatoes. You can add potatoes, carrots, peas, beans, any vegetable of your choice. Add a little water as this stew or gravy is on the runny side, but you can make it dry if you wish so. I like to serve it with crusty bread, so I like to make it a little runny. Now cook till the potatoes are done. By then the meat will also get cooked nicely. Once the potatoes are almost done, now you can add the ground masala. The masala is already roasted and fried, so you need not fry it. Just add it directly. When the curry comes to a nice rolling boil, add chopped coriander leaves. The gravy tends to thicken as it cools. And finally, I like to give a little tadka, but this is optional. Take a little oil in a pan, add a small onion sliced and a few curry leaves. Fry till the onion is nice and brown. But this is optional. You can skip this if you wish so. Once it's nice and brown, add it to the gravy. By now the gravy has thickened a little. Serve the tadka. Add the tadka and serve this nice when it is warm with some nice crusty bread, pav, or some steamed rice. I'm sure you too will like it. Do give it a try. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. So my dear friends, hope you have enjoyed this quick and yummy recipe. Stay tuned for more such interesting recipes. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye. See you soon with a new interesting recipe. Take care.